specific. When you say bill of material, what is the bill of material? When you say that any material, an article is made of certain components, so you know like what are all the subcomponents or components which make up the main article, the ratio, we mean like a ratio, or we could even say it as recipe. The recipe for the article is normally called as bill of material. For example, in this case, okay, which T-ATS99, which is the personal computer, okay, for which you had maintained the bill of materials as the materials ATW11, okay, that is high speed basic keyboard laser printer power screen, ATT11, ATU11, okay, ATB11. So these are all the components. Okay. So when you are buying a computer, there are two ways of it can be priced. One is in like is what it is given here. The main item is being priced, okay, and the sub items are not priced. In your case, you are maintaining a price for the computer, not just adding the sum of the additional items or sub items. Okay, so that is one option. Another option is your main item is not priced, which means your main item price is zero, and the system takes the prices of the sub items and adds everything together and fetches you the final price. Okay, so when you say that you want to maintain a separate price for main item, the price need not be the sum of your price of the sub item. Okay, which means even though the sub items can be sold separately as a separate article, when you put it together in form of some article, in your case, okay, it is a PC. Okay, when you put it together as PC, the price of your PC may be different from the addition of your sub items. Which means, let me say your sub items all put together, it costs you around $700. But you might want to, when we are selling as a package, you might want to sell it for 600 or 650. Okay. That is what it happened. Even though the system had a price for 140, okay, but you have maintained the price for your main item as 637. So that is what we are seeing in the condition records, PR00, 40-80S57, you have maintained. So ideally, let me say it must be somewhere around, yeah, so when you create, no problem, it's fine, actually it's my mistake, I should have taken it already. Okay, so just now we had talked that there are two ways of maintaining the pricing, one at the header level and one at the item level. Okay. So do you remember the item category determination? It is what it is. Yeah. Okay. 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 Item category. Yeah. Okay. In this, we normally use the item category as item category group as NORM, norm. Okay, so when an article is being handled with bill of material, it is now having a different item category. That is what that is what determines that this article is a bill of material item or non bill of material item. Okay, so we'll see. Can this item category group is maintained differently? That is 099. Okay. So when you say a normal item, okay, in standard we talk it as ERLA and LUMF, ERLA and LUM. So when you say ERLA, the system determines the item category. So we'll see that. Yeah, it determines TAQ and TAE. Okay. So, well, item category, assign item category. Okay. My document type is OR. My item category group is ERLA. The system determines TAQ. Okay. We can see what TAQ is. Slash O, V O V 7. There are two. Okay, second. TAQ. Extend deliver. You can see TAQ is relevant for normal pricing. Okay, the pricing is standard. Okay, this is standard pricing. Whereas, if I use the item category LUMF, here, if I use the item category LUMF, the system determines TAP, which means TAP is not relevant for pricing, which means the main item is not relevant for pricing. Okay, so I will slightly change your material here. Okay, I maintain it as ERLA. It is Z099. Okay, I will repeat that. No, for ERLA, the system determines price at the header level, which means for the main item, there will be pricing. Slash NDA01 OR00. T hyphen, what is that material number? ATS99. So it is T hyphen ATS99. Order quantity is 1. So, the system has exploded the bill of material. The item category for header item is TAQ and for sub item it has determined as TAE. Okay. So, if I go to the thing, I can see the price which just now we maintained, 6700. Previously it was just 700. Now, we maintain 6700. Okay. So, the system has taken the price for the main item. Okay. Repeat. Okay. So this is just now we maintain the price for PR00 for this article as 6700, so it has taken that. Which means the main item is priced. And if I go to the sub item, all the sub items are not priced. Okay. So let us change the item category to item category group to LUMS. T sales and ATS, that is found in the sales organization data 2. Instead of ERLA, I am maintaining it as LUMS. So then the system will determine an item category TAP, which we saw that it is not relevant for pricing. The system doesn't take the, so previously for the same bill of material our price was 6700. Okay, if I go into the pricing structure here, I can see the main item is not priced. Main item is C-ATS99. The main item is not priced. The sub items are priced. ATET11 is priced. ATU11 is priced. Okay. The system takes the sum of all your okay, fine. Yeah. Okay. Somewhere, I mean, it must have been taken when you took the item category. Okay. Somewhere it slipped out. Good that you brought it up. Okay. This is the bill of material concept. There are two things. If you talk in standard language, you could say there are two item category groups. ERLA, ERLA and LUMS, LUMS, LUMS. Okay. ERLA for the combination of item category OR, item category group ERLA, and the system provides the item category as TAQ. TAQ is relevant for pricing. Okay. And for the combination of OR, NOM and higher level item category TAQ, the system proposes a item category of TAE. TAE is not relevant for pricing, whereas it is relevant for delivery, schedule lines allowed. And for this configuration, you find that main item is priceable, whereas the sub items are not priced. And if you want the sub items to be priced as main items not to be priced, then you use the item category LUMF, LUMF, in your item category group. For the combination of OR and LUMS, the system determines the item category as TAP. TAP is not relevant for pricing, but it is relevant for your delivery, schedule lines allowed and other activities. But for the combination of OR, LUMS and the higher level item category TAP, the system determines the item category as TAN. TAN is our standard item category, which is relevant for pricing, having the schedule lines. So which means your main item is not priced and the sub items are priced. So the system adds up the sub items together, the prices of the sub items together, and fetches it as the value of the main item. Okay. So what are the types of billing we have created till now? For which documents and all we have created the billing? Yeah, for the invoice. No, invoice is the billing document. Okay. Yeah, F1, F2. For which you created the F1 or F2? Okay, till now we have been creating delivery. So when you go for VF01, okay, that is the billing. So what are the documents you enter here normally? No, this is the screen for creating the billing document. Okay. So in the document field, normally you enter the delivery. Okay. Which means you are billing for the delivery. There are some other scenarios where instead of delivery you enter the order number. Okay. That is, we had seen a scenario, do you remember? Okay, no problem. So for the cash sales we created an order related delivery. That is for order related billing. Okay. Whereas for your normal delivery you create a delivery related billing. When you say billing, billing is the final step of your sales and delivery process, which means you have made the sales order, you have made the delivery, and finally you are making the invoice for your service provided or goods delivered. Okay. So there are two types of billing. One is order related billing and another one is delivery related billing. Order related billing is nothing but you are billing for an order. So you don't bother about how much of the goods that has been that is present in the order that has been delivered. So you are just creating an order for, I mean, creating a billing for the order. Okay. Whereas there is something called a delivery related billing, which means you are billing whatever you have delivered, irrespective of what is found in the sales order. Okay. Normally, for product related things, we go for delivery related billing, because there could be a discrepancy in quantity between the sales order created as well as the delivered. Okay. Whereas in cash sales order, we created a order related billing, because the scenario of cash sales was that the customer has physically come into our premises, he has taken the goods, he is carrying the goods by himself. Okay. So which means we are not creating the delivery. So the customer, we have created the sales order, system automatically created a delivery. Okay. So just now, and we had seen that you cannot create a, yeah. For cash sales, no. For cash sales item, it is not. Because the customer himself picks the material and carries it away. No, at least, okay, the scenario is like, there is no availability check for cash sales, which means the customer walks into your premises and he takes the goods only which is available at this moment. Okay, for that the availability check is disabled. And, the customer himself, it doesn't mean that the customer physically he has to walk in and take it. With the help of your picker, he can do that, okay. The delivery item category for cash sales is BVN, which is not relevant for picking. Okay. So in cash sales scenario, there is no picking. Okay. Only the system just creates a delivery. Even the PGA is also done at a later stage using the collective processing. Okay. So in such cases, you go for a order related billing. And let us say, like, we are providing a service. So you are creating a sales order for a contract. I'm sorry, service contract. In the service contract, you don't have anything deliverable. Even though you say, like, my salesperson has to go to the customer's premises and carry out the service activity, there is nothing like physically deliverable goods, or you are not creating any delivery for that. In those scenarios, you have to create a billing based on your sales orders only. So just now we saw the item categories. The item categories say, okay, there is something called as billing relevance. Okay. These item categories only will determine what kind of billing it has to be, whether it has to be a delivery related billing or order related billing, according to this thing. Okay, our order related billing plan. So let us go to BVN, which is our cash sale. BVN, cash sale item. Your cash sale item, delivery billing relevance is relevant for order related billing, that is status according to order quantity. Okay. So this is one condition where it controls the what type of billing has to be done. Okay. The first control always comes from your sales document. So when you have customized the sales document, so let us go for a OR. Okay. So when you have configured the standard document type, the system says, from here only the system knows what must be your subsequent delivery type. That is, how the system should pick LS as delivery, that is defined here. Similarly, if you scroll down still little, you can find for this order, if it is going to be a delivery related billing, what should be. And if it is going to be the order related billing, what should be. Okay. So the first control for your billing document always comes from your document type, because in the document type only you say what is going to be your billing type. I believe since Priti has done the exercise, in the exercise their requirement was like the there should be a billing type which automatically carries out a new pricing when the billing is being created. Okay, which is the billing type you use? I think that is one of the questions there. Do you remember? That is the first question. That is the first task of your sales workshop exercise. Okay. Yeah. So, I mean, like the answer would have been like it should be F1, because the F1 document invoice type automatically carries out a pricing. Okay. That is what the answer is there. Okay. So, in the order type itself, you have to say what must be your corresponding delivery as well as the billing type. So the system takes your billing document type from your sales document, and second thing is your item category determines what kind of billing it has to be, whether the billing has to be done for sales order or the billing has to be done for the delivery creator. Okay. Because in the product industry, that is the when you're processing with the product, you normally create invoices for whatever you have delivered only. Okay. And in services, you create invoices for what services you have provided. There is no delivery, so you carry out for your sales order only. Okay. So that is the first difference. You have the order related delivery, billing, as well as the delivery related billing. And invoice is not the only billing document. We have something called as credit memo. We have debit memo. Any idea what a credit memo or debit memo is? Abid is so silent today. What happened? If everything goes so ideally in your business, there won't be any returns or there won't be any discrepancies. Okay. But in the real time, it is not like that. Sometimes you tend to create a delivery for 100 pieces. In actual, it could be only 95, or it could be 102. Okay, more than or less than what was the actually intended delivery. Okay, in such cases, you have to give some money to your customer, or you have to take some more money from your customer for the extra goods delivered. Okay, so in such cases, when you say that you have delivered something extra, okay, which means your customer owes you some more money, then you write a debit memo against your customer saying that you have to give me some more money. Okay. But in case of under delivery, which means you have overcharged your customer, then you are writing a credit memo to your customer saying that, sorry, I have overcharged you. I am writing a credit memo against you, which means I owe you so much of money to you. Okay. So this is the debit memo as well as the credit memo. And when you create returns, return sales orders, okay, you have delivered everything. Okay. After the delivery, the customer finds something as faulty and he comes back saying that, okay, this many quantities are faulty. Then you create a returns delivery. Just how you create a normal invoice for the delivery, you create a credit memo for returns. Okay. Then sometimes even your invoice itself is faulty. For example, you say that you have delivered 90 pieces. Okay. But actually delivered would have been 95 pieces or 85 pieces. Okay. Then you have to correct the invoice itself. So then you go for invoice correction request. Okay. So these are all the scenarios that These are all the kind of billing documents. Then you have something called as pro forma invoice. What is a pro forma invoice, anybody? Okay, in these scenarios you create, go for pro forma invoice. Can you collect payment against the pro forma invoice? Can you collect? No, Abid, my question is like, based on the pro forma invoice, can you collect money? No, you cannot. So basically, pro forma invoice gives a glimpse of what is your actual invoice. And by ideal scenario, you must invoice the goods only which you have delivered. Okay. So even though your delivery says 90, okay, the actual delivery could have been 85 to 95. Okay, anything in between. Okay. Then, if your customer says I have received 92, then you have to write an invoice for 92 pieces. If your customer says that he has received only 85, then you have to write an invoice for 85 pieces. Okay. But, okay, for, especially when the goods are crossing the border, either state or countries, you have to declare the value of your goods that is crossing the border. Okay. In such cases, you have to tell them what is the value of the invoice. Okay. But, you will be arising the actual invoice only after the customer confirms the goods received. Okay. So, what you do, you normally create an invoice called pro forma invoice. Pro forma invoice is a dummy invoice. Okay. You can create any number of pro forma invoice, but and it won't hit the accounts. Okay. No matter you may, yeah. Yeah. Ideally speaking, the moment the goods, once you do the PGA, the ownership is automatically transferred to the customer according to SAP. Okay. However, this depends on the agreement between you and the customer. Who pays for the insurance? So those kind of things. And sometimes like you pay the cost, insurance and freight. Sorry. Sometimes you pay the insurance and freight and while quoting your price itself, which means like if something is happening, the insurance will be reimbursed to you. Sometimes you quote the export price, which means the moment goods leave the your premises, quoting the price, only for your premises. So, which means the customer is taking all the responsibility of goods outside your premises, which means the ownership is transferred entirely. Okay. That is a dicey question and that depends on the agreement between you and your customer. There is no definite answer like not necessary, but why should that agreement bother you while creating the billing for what you are delivered? Yeah, we are charging for that. Okay. And the pro forma invoice just says, okay, this is the value of goods that is being carried. Okay. So you have to declare the value of the goods in the customs normally. Okay. So for that purpose, we are creating the pro forma invoices. Okay. So pro forma invoice can be created even before proof of delivery or even, So irrespective of number of times you create a pro forma invoice for a same delivery, it will not affect your account entry. Okay. So that is the pro forma invoice. So these are all some of the billing documents we are going to see. So till now, today Preeti had created some sales order. Okay, she had created a billing document itself. That is fine really. Okay. So normally we go to VF01, we enter the delivery number, okay, then we create the system, then press enter, the system automatically creates the billing document. So when you create the billing document, it's not only the billing document, you go to the accounting overview and you can find in the accounting document. So what is there in the accounting document? It says to which account how much of value has to be posted to. So which means for the against the customer account you are saying 7072.52, which means you say the customer has to pay as 7072. Okay. Out of which you split these into further components. Out of this 7000 something, your sales revenue is only 6000. Okay. Your deductions are this. Okay. And okay, 6000 and 7700. So these are your sales components, revenue components. Okay. 975 is the tax component, whereas the 540 and 63 are your discounts. Okay. So if you see the account corresponding account number, the components like your revenue component, tax component and discount components are taken to separate accounts. Okay. So when you are carrying out a when you are creating a billing document, the system not only creates a billing document, it automatically posts to the relevant accounts. That is by using a technique called as account determination. Okay. Just hold on. So, in the billing document, the system automatically determines, accounting document automatically determines which account the price component has to be posted to and as well as to the which profit center. Okay. The profit center account numbers are automatically, are created by the finance people, and the determination part has to be done by us, because if you remember the pricing procedure, we had a separate column called as account key, that is in the 15th column from left. Okay, so we had something called as account key. Account keys had something called as ERL, ERS, ERB. Okay, so based on that account key, the system determines the corresponding account which it has to be posted to. Okay. So Preeti, how did you come to this invoice? Yeah. How? Click that billing. Okay. Okay, fine. Yeah. Okay, just a center. Okay, it came here. Okay, fine. Okay. So, in fact, since the billing document is the final part of our process, there is nothing like data entry or something. To be relevant, there is no complete incompletion log for your billing document. You have incompletion log for your sales order. You have incompletion log for your delivery also. Okay. But there is no incompletion log for your billing document, because the system just picks up the previous completed document, that is either the sales order or delivery, and then create the billing document for that. Okay. So let us create a sales order. Okay. One is the let us see two scenarios. One is order related billing and delivery related billing. Billing. So when is my delivery is 30 and my plant is 1200, okay. So I'll try to deliver this. I don't know whether it's going to get disconnected. No. So when it's over, it's 1308. Okay, go for the picking. Are you people comfortable with the delivery process? Because that is one area where nobody finds comfortable. Even in my certificate, my 3 month session, that will be taken for 3 days. Okay, so all those 3 days, students will normally be sleeping. So the trend goes like during the sales order creation and other thing, so they will be quite enthusiastic because that is the first time for them. Okay. Then we come to pricing. That excitement peaks basically. So they are learning new things, condition technique. Everybody gets excited with that condition technique. Okay. When you come to delivery, that's it. All the excitement dies. And okay, like after that, that is the third week of our session. We come to the billing part. Okay. So when you come to billing, okay, because the account determination and everything is having the condition technique again. So they will be happy to get back into the track. So I think for this customer, we are having the proof of delivery. So I go to log, I think that, okay. So however, if I want to create a separate, I mean like by default, I am not entering any document type here, okay. All I did was I just entered the document number and press the enter. The system is trying to create a billing document type F2 because of my sales document type customizing. But if I want to create a pro forma invoice now, I have to explicitly say what is going to be my billing type. So let me scroll down here. Pro forma for. Perform invoice for delivery. Okay. So even though I didn't carry out a proof of delivery, okay. So without carrying out a proof of delivery, I won't be able to create an invoice. That's what these are now. Okay. But this is a dummy invoice which is going to be supplied along with the delivery itself. So I am able to create a perform invoice for delivery without carrying out any proof of delivery. So now I will take a printout of this document and I will send it along with the delivery. Okay. So let me carry out here proof of delivery for the VLPOD. Okay. Then I confirm that I have received so and so. Now I will be able to carry out here billing activity for this. So this is the difference between your actual invoice and the pro forma invoice. Okay. So this is the delivery related billing. We are billing the customer for on the basis of what we have delivered. Okay. There is a scenario cash sales we will see. So EA01. Okay. Instead of OR, let me use the document as CA. SD-A02 cash sales billing. Okay, fine. Okay. The specialty of cash sales is, any idea? Do you remember? You have done. No, delivery will be created automatically. The delivery is automatically created. Yeah. Okay, now let me say the customer is standing along with me. Okay, so he wants a billing. Okay, but what we normally do, we can take a printout of this and we give it as a invoice or billing for that customer. Okay, but in actual we have to carry out all the PGA activities for that. Okay, so I will go to change VL02N / VL02N. I think it is 5052. Yeah, change outbound delivery 5052. Okay. Can you see the system has automatically created a transfer order and confirmed, which means you didn't explicitly do any picking activities. Okay, so I do a PGA. Okay, by going by the actual business process, we must be creating a delivery for we must be creating a billing for what we had delivered. That is, we must have created a delivery related billing. But let us see what happens now. / N VF01. The system takes the sales order. For the same sales order which you had created the delivery and even done your PGA, the system didn't bother about the delivery. Instead, it is billing for your order quantity. Okay, that is the cash sale DV. Can you see the, in the header you can see the cash sale invoice. This is not the F2 invoice. F2 invoices are always created for your delivery, whereas this cash sale invoice is created for your order. Okay, this is your order related billing as well as the delivery related billing. Okay, so we will catch up with the other types of deliveries, billing documents like your debit, credit as well as the invoice corrections tomorrow. Okay. Yeah, yeah. Which one? Yeah. Okay, do one thing, like search for TSCM62 in rapid library. Yeah.